A lot of people have been asking me about the OpenAI o1 model, which is known for its reasoning capabilities. For me, where this model really shines is in its ability to keep track of a lot of details in large amounts of messy data. That is where the power comes from. Now, one way I think about this is its ability to tackle complexity and these complex problems. We all have complex problems to solve in our lives. And for me, one of my big challenges is figuring out summer camp schedules for my kids every summer. It is not a task I enjoy and something I would gladly have an AI do for me. So let me show you how I was able to use the o1 model to do this. This is what my prompt looks like. I ask it to plan a weekly schedule for all three of my kids for the summer of 2024, and I gave it the specific dates. I have some constraints here, because at its essence, this is a huge constraint satisfaction problem, where I want it to have 2 weeks for them to not be in camps where all of us are off together for some family time. And then I gave it some information about each of my children, including what grade they're entering, because that will be important, as well as each of their interests. And then I specified that I want my output to be a matrix of each week of the summer by each kid with the title of the class that they're in. Then the next thing I had to do was to give it some data to use to solve this problem. Now, what I use for this is a catalog, and it looks something like this. So you can see there is a lot going on in this formatting. We have the grade levels. Each of these camps are a single week. So for example, if you look at this chess camp, this one is only offered as a week long, the week of July 15th or the week of July 22nd. So it has to use those constraints. Camps are also limited to certain grades. So you see that this chess camp is only available to grades 5 and 6. So there's a lot of details that this model is going to have to keep track of between the information that I've already given it about my children, as well as all of the information in this catalog. Now, here's an example of one run of the model output. Now, the most impressive thing I saw here is that there were no hallucinations or mistakes in this data. So each class that is shown here is actually offered during that time frame, and each class is one that actually applies to the grade level that my child is in. So in just 1 minute, as compared to the hours or days it would take for me to do this planning myself, the model was able to give me a very, very good example of what our summer program could look like. So the key takeaway for you should be, when you have a problem that involves large quantities of messy data, where maybe the signal to noise ratio is more on the noise side, the o1 model is very, very powerful at keeping track of large amounts of nuanced data and giving intelligent responses to your problem.